So, okay, I'm gonna clue that in, because I need it to be stable, but I may regret it.
Welcome back to the Miniart Sdkfz.234/2 Puma build series. In part 6, we're focusing on adding the intricate fuel injection lines to the Tatra 103 diesel engine, bringing this model closer to life. Let's get started.
Okay, this is really difficult, especially because I'm doing it under the camera. If I were to do this without the camera, it probably would be easier. So, all right, so is that gonna go in there for me or what? All right, I don't think it's going to go in the hole, unfortunately. I may just do the one to show you how I'm going about it, and then just do the rest off camera, because this is a pain.
So what I did as an experiment is I'm using my looper with some CA glue, and I'm running it on the lead wire because maybe it'll help strengthen it. Anyway. Okay, going back in for the next one. So this time what I think I'm gonna do is add it here first, because it might be easier to line it up later. I don't know why this one's not going in. Should I try and drill those out or just glue it? Nah, I should try and glue it. Not a deep drill, but at least it'll better than a butt joint. So dipping it in and sticking it in. There you go. So let's do that. We're gonna try and do a factory. Shiza, that one broke. Holy shit, I missed this one completely. I can't believe I didn't get that one. All right, so that's dried, so we can bring it around. It's amazing how much hair and crap get in there. Okay. All right. Damn it. Fuck. Ah, you goddamn mother! All right, I gotta rethink this.
Okay, well, I've skipped ahead a little bit here, and I've managed to get half of it done. Now, after I completed this, I took a look at it, and it's not a perfect representation, I feel, of these fuel injection tubages. I think I maybe was using the reference from Munster as somewhat of a reference, and it probably isn't as routed as tightly as what I see in later reference issues I've seen, where you know, the pipage is very organized and regulated. But, you know, for my first attempt, I'm pretty happy with it. I'm not really sure if I would use the solder from Plus Models again. I find that it seems to have certain points along its length where it actually is prone to sort of like break. So I'm thinking if I were to ever do this again, I would buy a resin 3D print of the engine. No, I'm kidding. You can get those, but I don't know if they're actually perfect either. The thing is I think compared to the other model kits out there with this engine installed, like I guess RFM, I think this is a better representation of the engine. I think it looks more accurate. And the one from CMK, the resin one from bygone days, yeah, I believe this one, again, from Miniart is more accurate. Next time, what I might do is take more time and actually make some jigs to actually bend the wire prior to gluing them in place. But, you know, I was excited. I wanted to get this model built, and yeah, so. But next time, maybe I'll try a little bit harder. In any case, I ended up putting the cover on top of the engine area on the back of the Puma, and you can't really see this much anyway, so. But it was a good learning exercise on how this all kind of went together. All right, well, it's a good thing that Miniart makes this sort of like foolproof in some ways. I'm going to be adding these, I don't know, I'm not sure if they're exhaust or import. I haven't figured that out yet. But basically, you have a pin and a hole. Now, they are distinct. I believe, if you look at the instruction sheet, this one goes this way, and then the other one will go that way because of the way they've taken care of the holes, I think. No, skip all that.
Okay, I'm going to scratch some of the paint away. Thank you. I'm just going to put this on without adding the other side pieces, because with it being in place like this, it may be easier to stick those on. All right, I goofed and I glued these wrong. I don't know what happened there. Back to the beginning. All right. I'm glad I was able to fix that. So now, looking at the instructions, I can see where these should go, which is right there. All right, So something I noticed when I glued this in is there's a bit of a seam. So when I glued this in, I noticed there was a seam that I forgot to clean up or didn't notice. All right. Same here on the front. All right. So now that fits. What do you think about that, eh? Okay, M48. Okay, so that goes on. Now, M41 and M42. These are the ones that I need to put on. Here's 41. Now that one goes. Okay, that goes up. All right, so we've got that. That's weird. Let's see. So that goes like that. Thank you. Is there a difference in these? I don't know. I don't think so. All right, yeah, I made a mistake. I guess these are handed, and I didn't realize there was two of them. So, yeah. Thank you. All right. Yeah, you can see this is bigger on the top than on the bottom. Okay, let's take care of these fan belts, glue them in place. So this, okay, that one goes there like that. Or is that 27? Yeah, it's 27. That goes on this one right there. Shoot. Thank you. Okay, let's... Sweet. Alright, I painted this part, number 48, painted it black, it's got a silver undercoat though. Alright. All right. Now, let's see how these are gonna fit.
Alright, that wraps up this episode on scratch building the fuel injection plumbing for the Tatra 103 diesel engine. It was a bit of a challenge, but these small details really bring the model to life. I hope you enjoyed watching the process and picked up some useful tips along the way. In the next episode, we'll continue refining the engine and work on even more detailing. As always, if you've got any questions or feedback, drop them in the comments below. Thanks for tuning in, and I'll see you next time. So in the meantime, and in between time, that's another edition of Jet Scale Models. Y'all come back now, you hear?
Yeah, I should've. Should have glued it here, and then I can take the engine out, which is what I'm gonna do. Alright, so there we go. Finally finished. Okay. Now.